All right, let's talk about the ladies now. Let's start from the lowest level. Let's talk about the FIFA Under 17 Women's World Cup qualifier. Well, a year or two ago, if anybody told me that we're going to be in this kind of situation, I probably would say no, it can never happen. But guess what? We're in a situation where we're going to Cameroon, we need an outright win or a score draw that involves more than two goals. So, for instance, say 3-3, 4-4, I mean, and it goes higher. And I'm still dazed looking at this. I never thought Cameroon would come to Nigeria and pick a role. But the girls working on teen heist, they need to go to Cameroon. A win? I mean, that's the only way to qualify.
These young girls, I've just wondered the kind of pressure that is put, you know, that are brought to bear on these young girls. Of course, they've always had their predecessors, how they've qualified for every edition of the Under 17 World Cup.
No Under 17 set failed to qualify.
If they don't go to this World Cup, it will be on record that this is the first set.
On that,
this is the first set of Under 17
that
girls
failed
that failed to qualify. And so, and I'm sure that the team handlers would have been drumming this into their ears and all of that. We saw, we've always known that Cameroon, we know the kind of threat they pose. It's been a while they've been coming, they've been working, and each time Nigeria was always a big, you know, had that perhaps maybe advantage over them, and we're getting the result. This time around, ended 2-2. But one other thing I know with this team is it's on record that they've not won any game.
Yeah.
Their first game was against Ethiopia. They played one all away.
Had to rely on a draw.
Had to. On a way goes qualifies.
Why
for the
do
next
we
one.
Fail to see the danger signals? We'll see.
It's been coming. It's been coming. I don't know whether perhaps maybe just maybe we are not producing enough girls at that level to compete, or you're just maybe we might have decided.
We are recycling. Some have said.
No, or maybe we have decided finally. We have decided finally to say, okay, we want to play this competition with under 17 girls.
Oh, okay.
Or perhaps we've decided to recycle and the rest of them.
That one has weight.
Okay. That, of course, I don't know. Because it depends on what the coaches are. But I think Coach Bala and Q is not a new customer to things like this. So we expect, I'm sure that anybody who follows women's football in Nigeria will say, okay, we expect the girls somehow to get the result.
Okay.
But it's not looking good.
And this is the game. Bitter memories, some sloppy defending. I mean, we scored first, early minutes of the game, and just when you thought, okay, fine, Cameroon will be there for the taking, they get two goals in the first half, and we're almost winning the game. And some have said it's not an issue of quality, but, you know, something went wrong.
Maybe it's a question of when you play against a team that is, you know, wants to take the fight to you, refusing to lie down and get beaten, it happens, and you can't say that the experience of these girls, good goal, well taken goal. If we see more of this in the
how they get to do this in Cameroon?
I hope they just get to do that. But the Cameroonians, you know, in your face, you came to Yaoundé when we hosted Cameroon hardly hosts anything. They hosted the African Women's Champion, the African Women's Nations Cup. You beat them
on home soil.
And
if we're going to advance, we can't be conceding goals like this.
Not like this.
We just can't be. Let's see if we can. I mean, this is a game against Cameroon, but let's look at Nigeria's past appearances at the FIFA Under 17 Women's World. And like Alfred hinted earlier, we have never failed to qualify. We have appeared at every edition of the Under 17 Women's World Cup. Let's see, like a scorecard, what has happened every time we participated in that tournament. Let's go see if we can bring that to you. The Flamingos' appearances at the Under 17, and hopefully 2018 will not be an exception. This is it, Alfred. I mean, 2008 at the group stage, quarterfinals. I mean, the last time was at the group stage, but three times we've been at the quarterfinals, twice we've been at the group stage. I mean, a team like that should not be failing to qualify.
Well, when you say a team like that, this is past. And you know, for international football, this is the entry level.
Yeah.
So what you get at the end of the day as your best that comes to the exit is the best that you can get at that time. And so for our girls here, hopefully.
Hopefully. Okay.
Hopefully we'll get something from this.